Bam.
Okay. So if I type get mood. Ah, there we go. ISD is here. Hello. Okay, it worked. Create an Ethereum dApp with Ether.js. Okay, interesting. Step-by-step tutorial on how to create a front-end, deploy a Solidity smart contract and connect them together. We will use MetaMask, RemixIDE and Ether.js. Okay, by the end of the tutorial, we'll be able to create a simple HTML front-end with buttons that can interact with smart contract functions. The tutorial takes place in three stages. Create a basic HTML web page, create a base Solidity smart contract, connect the web page with the smart contract using Ethers.js. Do not install MetaMask. Okay. Click Ethereum mainnet in the top. Change it to the ROPS10 testnet and get a copy of the account's public address on your MetaMask wallet. Okay, so this one can be tricky. Okay, so let's go on MetaMask. Okay, so here there is a problem in the tutorial because they say click the Ethereum mainnet on the top, change to ROPS10 testnet. Someone can really feel lost here. I am on the MetaMask. Here I can change it in a minute. You need to go on the settings. Download. Show test network. Okay, so now change to ROPS10. There we go. Faucet link to request phones. I hope that this works. Successfully. Install a HTTP server. Use any you like, but we recommend lit server for beginners. Install Node.js, install lit server version. Okay, let's try this. So let's create a basic HTML page. Let's see. Mkdir learn web3. Create an index.html file and then we create this some HTML boilerplate. Okay, we'll create an app that simply reads and writes a value to the blockchain. We'll need a label, an input and button. Set the body tag. Okay, let's add this in the body. Okay, set the div tag. The div tag add some buttons. Okay. Okay, so we're basically creating something very basic, but okay. Optional, instead the head tag add some style to make it look a bit better. So this is in file CSS. Serve the web page via terminal command prompt. Let's see. Okay. Get mode, set mode. Okay. Your front end is now complete. Create a basic smart contract. Now it's time to create a Solidity smart contract. You can use an editor you like to make control. For this order, we recommend an online IDE Remix. Go to Remix, check out Solidity compiler and deploy and run transaction step. Create a new Solidity file called mood.sol. Mood.sol. So we need to write the license. This is the Solidity version. We need to define a contract. And something that I really like about Solidity is that you can define class using the keyword contract. So it's very explicit of what's going on. Contract mood diary. Inside the contract, create a variable called mood. Next, create read and write functions. Okay, so string mood. So this is a state variable outside any function. Create a read and write function. Create a function that writes a mood to the smart contract, writes a mood and reads the mood. Okay, this is a nice example. I like it. So this is a function to set the mood, string memory mood public, and here. And okay, here is getting interesting a bit more. We wrote a very simple smart contract. Deploy the contract on the ROPS10 testnet. Make sure your MetaMask is connected with the ROPS10 testnet. So ROPS10 test network here. Make sure you select the right compiler version to match the Solidity contract. Okay, so here Solidity 0.8.1. If we go on the Solidity, I think this should work. Compile the code using the Solidity compiler tab. Note that it may take a moment. Okay. Compile. So we compiled this smart contract that we wrote using the Remix IDE. Deploy the contract under the deploy and run transactions tabs. I'm here. Deploy the contract under the deploy and run transactions tab. Okay, now things are getting more interesting. Okay. Remix VM London. Under the deployed contract sections, you can test out your functions on the Remix Run tab to make sure your contract works as expected. In Jetpack Provider. Okay, so this is wrong, because it says injected provider MetaMask in the tutorial is injected Web3 environment. Make a new temporary file to hold the deployed contract address. Copy it via the copy button next to the deployed contract, pull down your Remix Run tab. Here, let's deploy it. When you deploy, it connects this one. I think it's this one, right? The deployed contract. Deployed section. Francesco looks cool. Nice. And the contract ABI, copy it via the copy button under the contract Remix compile tab. Where is ABI? Copy. So we have, this is the contract address and this is the ABI. Connect your web page to your smart contract. Back in your local text editor in index.html, so in the local environment when I have the index.html, add the following code to your HTML page. Import the ether.js source into your index.html page inside a new set of script tags. I think this is here, because we are importing the CDN. Inside a new set of script tags. Inside the script tag, import the contract ABI and specify the contract address on your provider blockchain. So we need another script here. Don't know if this goes in the head. I think it goes in the body. For the contract ABI, we need to specify navigate to JSON section. So in this script, we can do this. Contract ABI. So let's see. Is this like literally the ABI or is it a link? Since we have two methods, this should start as an array with two objects. Okay, an array with two objects. Let's see if it's true. It is an array with two objects. From the above page, each object should have the following input: constant inputs name, output payable, set mutability, and type. For set mode, we describe each field below. Name, set mode, self-explanatory. Okay, so input, name, output, state mutability, and type. Inputs, name, output. Okay. Next, define an ethers provider. In your case, it is Robston. So const provider, new ethers provider, the web provider window, Ethereum Robston. Okay, interesting. Const provider, new ethers. Provider with three provider. Okay. Request access to the user's wallet and connect the signer to your MetaMask account. We use zero as default and define provider send. I think at the end we will have a sort of final file. So we provider ET request account, list of accounts, get signed. So okay, so this is basically to sign up using ethers. Create anonymous function to call your smart contract functions. Create asynchronous functions to call your smart contract functions. Function get mood, function set mood. Okay. Okay. I'm not sure if the script should be here in the body and here the script in the head, because this is an import. They also have the clone of this. I want to see if the code looks similar. Let's see, index.html. So we have meta style, body, div. Okay, the script is in the body. Let's try to... contract address. I forgot this. Interesting. After this, we can make a good stop with a coffee. I'll try to explain everything, but this is getting very, very, very interesting. We just need to type light server here. So if I type like hello, set mode. Okay, new guest experience, confirm. Okay, contract deployment. Activity lot transaction data. So let's see, 1, 2, 3. So the set mode seems that it works. Okay, so if I type get mode. There we go. ISD is here. Hello. Okay, it worked. Everything worked. Amazing. If you use a smart contract address to pass the assessment for this level. Okay, I think it's this.
Bam. Bam.